everyone, it's Sally from the Piggy Room here. I've just bought these two wooden houses for guinea pigs off eBay. When I got them, they weren't this colour, they were just plain wood. So, as usual, I had to make them pink. So, I've painted them with my favourite plaster coat project enamel in hot pink. And that's a water-based enamel, which is perfectly safe for children and pets alike. So I've painted them both pink. I wanted to do some sort of pattern on them. You might have seen my video where I put stars all over Domino's shelf. It took me so long to do it. I really couldn't face hand painting something on again. And I couldn't find a stamp of something I liked. So I've bought these stickers. They're from Hippie Motors, which is a company I've used before. I've actually got some stickers of guinea pigs on my cage from them. You can have, mainly they make stickers for cars, which are a lot larger than these, but they also do quite a few small stickers for things like putting on your bike or your laptop or whatever. So after a lot of dithering, I decided to go for flowers, and these are the ones I got. I've got one set of silver, one set of fuchsia, and one set of vibrant green. When you take them off, the centre comes out separately from the outside of the sticker, so you can change the colours around, so you can have a green flower with a pink centre and vice versa. They come with instructions on how to put them on. You're supposed to do it wet, which is what I've done before when I put it on the coroplast on the guinea pigs' cages. I'm not too sure how well that'll work on wood, but I'll give it a go. Also, just that's the letter I got with, or the invoice I got with the stickers. They're a very good company, very quick at supplying stickers. They basically came 2 days after I ordered it. And I think they will also make anything, that any stickers in various sizes that you want. And they always put a little personalised message on there, and some free stickers. This time I've got three butterflies. So I'm going to give it a go. I'm not going to film it all because I think it's going to take ages. But I'll be back soon and show you what it's like when it's finished. Okay, well, I've done them. I did one with green and silver and the other one with pink and silver. That house, for some reason, has come out a paler pink than that one. So I couldn't really put the pink on there because it didn't show up. So I decided to do one pink and silver and one green and silver. The only problem with that was I only had one sheet of silver, so I haven't put as many flowers on there as I intended. But they've still come out quite well. It's very easy to do. You just peel off the sticker you want, dip it in some soapy water, and then place it roughly where you want it. And then while it's still wet, you can slide it around to get it just in the right position. And then you pick a corresponding flower from the other sheet of paper, again dip it in the water and put it in the centre. I don't know whether you can see this, but they're very flat on the surface. There's nothing there for the guinea pigs to get their teeth around to pull them up. And also you can't get them off except with a hairdryer when you heat them. So I think they're pretty guinea pig proof, hopefully. So that's the one with the green and silver stickers. I've put them in sort of a random pattern, sort of bit of a pattern on the top, but otherwise they're just pretty random. And this is the pink and silver one, where I've made a bit more of a pattern of it. I think I prefer that one. I'm not really sure, that one's a bit more, I don't know, funky. So anyway, I'm quite pleased with them. Hopefully the guinea pigs will like their new houses. I'm sure they won't care what colour I've painted them or what flowers have stuck on them. Anyway, thank you for watching and bye for now.